Mary John Mujok, a South Sudanese citizen, says she was arrested and kept in a dungeon for 8 months after being accused of collaborating with wrong elements. She says she was also raped by her abductors.
They will cover my face, but in my brain I'm counting the people who have been using me that time, because there were 6 people.
All of the 6?
Yeah. They put me back to the country, to the prison, not to my home, to our home, to the prison, after 3 days when I was in the bush. And then they took me back. When my family asked about me, they say we have already killed her. And I was there in the prison down for 8 months and 3 weeks. And then even my family, they have already prepared for my last prayer in the family, because I've already died, that is why.
Mujok says the trauma has haunted her, but music is helping her recover.
I was traumatized. Because it's not easy. You will be raped and you will not be taken to the doctor, because I was there for 8 months. I'm thinking maybe I'm going to get different symptoms like HIV, gonorrhea, and those things. I was traumatized about that, and all 8 months I finished it. Like, I'm seeing myself, if I see somebody like that is special than me, I will hide myself, like they want to kill me or what. So after they release me, I really follow doctor for 1 year. I have to make clear there is no any sickness, not HIV. And I was so grateful when they tested me, they said, Mary, you don't have HIV AIDS. And again, the second year, I went back again. So I'm comfortable with that, because no any sickness attached.
Etting says she was offered by her clan as compensation for a man her father had killed. The culture dictates that a young girl be given as compensation to another clan for a person killed. She was only 16 years old when she was offered. She says she suffered sexual violence at the hands of her new family, living with them from 1995 to 2004. Etting, after surviving in that situation, eventually fled to Uganda. Evelyn Amoni was abducted by the Lord's Resistance Army in 1994 at the age of 14. While in the bush, she was forced to become one of the wives of Joseph Kony, the rebel outfit's commander. When she escaped from the LRA and returned home, she started the Women Advocacy Network, an organization to help women who have gone through sexual violence. Sylvia Achan formed an organization called Golden Woman Vision Uganda to help women who have gone through sexual violence. The organization uses both music and counseling to help women who have undergone sexual violence. Achan says women are encouraged to speak about their trauma.
A person opens up and tells about her stories, and out of that story, they started beginning to write their own stories. And out of the story, we get the beats and then begin to make the music. At the end of it all, even a vulnerable person could begin to sing and smile, and it creates hope for her to live in the future.
Apolline Pearson, the program manager for Dr. Mukwege Foundation, an organization that works to rehabilitate trauma survivors, says they have treated over 70,000 people since the year 2000.
In 1999, he founded a hospital called Panzi in the city of Bukavu in the eastern part of the country. As most of you may know, Congo is a country that has been affected by wars for decades, and one of the most prominent features of that conflict was the use of rape as a weapon of war. So Dr. Denis Mukwege started his hospital for maternal care, and then he realized that there were a lot of women that came in because they had been raped with extreme violence. And so he started treating sexual violence survivors. Today in 2022, he treated more than 70,000 survivors of sexual violence. And for that work, he got the Nobel Peace Prize in 2018 alongside Nadia Murad.
Report by Claude Omona in Gulu.